Hi, in this video we will review how to work with the metadata of the system. Firstly, we should select add this metadata to the HUSKY filter. There is two ways, by hands and automatically. So, let's review by hands. What we can do just now is add data, for example, width and height. So let's do this. Let's name them. This is labels, all the fields which will be destroyed in the top structure. Next, here we can select how to display our meta fields. So, as we have number fields, because height and width is a number, we can select slider and leave this as number. Save changes. Let's go to the bottom of the structure. And you can see our filter section added. So let's enable them, let's place them on the top, okay, and let's press save changes. Let's go to the front side, and now you can see it's ready. Just now you can make filtering by width and height. So it works. Okay. Next, what we can do with these filter sections? We can do something about additional options. Let's go into in and look on it. So, what we can do next? Show title label. It's just enabling or disabling title label. Show toggle button. This is toggle button for the filter section. So, let's leave it selected as open it, apply, save changes, refresh. And as you can see, will appear a toggle button. By the way, text or image of this button you can change in top design. Next, what we can do? So let's add tooltip information if we need it. Also, we can select step. Just now by default it's step by one. So we can see here only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But what if we want to set it to 5? Let's select it to 5. Apply, save changes, refresh the page. And now you can see if to move range slider, it will be step 5. Look, 6, 11, 16. But what's the number? Let's go to additional options and select here arrange. From 0 to 100, apply, save changes, refresh the page, and try again, 5, 10, 15, 20, and also. Okay, let's go back to the additional options, and what we can do here next, prefix and postfix. As it's width, we can set here postfix, for example, centimeters. Okay, let's apply, save change, refresh the page, and as you can see, width in centimeters. Just now it's more pretty with postfix. Okay, let's look more. Show inputs. What does it mean? Your users can make filtering dragging slider, but what if they want to use text inputs? So let's enable them. Yes, apply, save changes. Refresh. And as you can see just now, your users can make filtering just by input the data they want. For example, 25. Enter. And as you can see, it works and also on another way. And last but not least, skins. So for example, here you can select skins for your slider. So let's select, for example, skin modern. Apply. Save change, and as you can see, it's another. You can play with these skins as you want. So what we can do next? Let's look how to add meta fields using product ID. So for example, let's go here and look on this product. 1816. Okay. Enter. And as you can see, there is a lot of meta fields you can see. And what you can leave here. and it's just your business how you want to use it. If you do not need any meta fields, just remove them. So I removed all meta fields we do not need, and as you can see, there is some metadata which is in the system. So let's enable them. Let's wait. So we have length, weight, it's also type number, and it's better to use slider here. Total sales, if you want, you can leave it, of course. So let's leave it, let's rename it a little. It's also number, and leave it as is. Save changes. New filter section on the structure bottom, let's enable them. Options are the same, so let's leave it as is. And press save changes. Refresh the page. Let's go to the bottom and see. We can make filtering using length. And weight. Okay. And let's try total sales. Is there any effect about this? Yes, it works. By the way, all data which is using biometa fields should be already in the system. So if you created a new meta field, it will not work. So let me demonstrate you. So we are going to the metadata and let's add any meta field. Hello, add. Hello, let's be slider number, save changes. Let's go to the bottom and enable it. Save changes. Let's go to the side front. And as you can see, system even not even displayed it because we have enabled dynamic recount. Because there is no any product has this data. So what we should do? Let's go to the beer bulk editor and add this. Okay, save. Let's add it to the system. So what we're doing just now, we want to add data about this metadata to each product. Just now we have nothing, 000, but in the reality, just added new meta field has no data for each product. So it's even not zero. So let's set the data for this field. Okay, let's go here, set new, for example, 5. We can select set new or increase by value. 5. Do bulk edit. So it's done. Let's go to the side front and look. We can see hello here. It's just 5 for each product. Let's set new data, for example, 125. And let's make any filtering. So it found something. And we found products which is in the range between 1 and 23. So it's all about metadata and WooCommerce metafields, but we have such amazing plugin as ACF. So I created group of metafields and just created new metafield. It's also number. So we created it and let's copy this key. We just copied it by clicking. Let's go to our tab metadata and paste it here and press add. It's number and let it be slider because for number slider is the best. Okay, save changes. Let's go to the bottom of the structure. Enable it. Save changes. We see this ACF number field. So let's try to make filtering. Yes, we found just one product. Because before doing this video, I already made test and left value for this product. We can look it's here. Let's go and try to order. As you can see, yes, we have one product about this. Okay. The same way, you can set the data for another products. For example, 50, 75, 90. Let's go bottom And let's select 70. We found already something. And 91. Even 90. That's all. All the products which had the data will be found. Let's add another meta field using ACF plugin. Add field. For example, let's select text. Click on field name, it's created automatically. Let's leave it as is. And close field, save changes. Let's copy this key. Go back to metadata and add it. And select here search by text. Here we should select string. Save changes. Go to the bottom and let's enable it. Look on this additional option. So here is only one option. How to look text we should use like. So for example, if the metadata value is, for example, text about, so it's just enough to enter about, or exact. So if it's exact, user should enter exact value of the meta field. Just now, let's leave it as like. Apply. Save changes. Refresh the page. Go to the bottom. And as you can see, it's created text input. Just now we have nothing, but anyway, let's try to find something. Nothing. We found nothing because, as I described already, metadata should be needed. Meta field here. Text input string. Okay. Save meta fields. So to find something, we should need it. Okay. There is empty. Let's do something. Hello. World. Take it. Okay. Let's go to the side front. And right here, hello. And sure, we found one product, which is needed as hello. So let's enter take. Reset firstly. Just take. Take. Yes, it's found. Because we have selected additional option as like. But what about if we select exact? Apply, save changes, refresh the page. Let's go to our input. Let's enter. Take. Will be found nothing. But let's also write. Take it. Is found one product. So this is all about metadata. Now I hope you understood how to work with this. In the next video, we will review Husky shortcodes. How to work with it and how to create filters with the set of filter sections you need for your business. See you. Bye.